Hi guys, in this tutorial, we will learn how to create this cipher style kinetic typography animation without using any plugins. Let's get started. Let's create a new composition. We'll call this as main. Keep it 920 by 1080 and press on OK. Now for the letter, we'll need a new composition. Let's just click over here. Before setting the width and the height, think what is going to be your final word. In case your word is going to be 8 letters, just divide the width as well as the height by 8. That way later on all the lines will fit perfectly horizontally and vertically. In my case, I am writing simply put. So as it has 9 letters, I am going to divide both the width and height by 9. So coming over here, simply divide this by 9. Automatically, as you are ticked over here, our height also got divided by 9. We'll name this as letter 1 and press on OK. Now inside this composition, we have to add 4 things. Firstly, we'll add a background. For that, let's create a solid layer. I'm just going to call it as BG. Keep it as black and press on OK. Next, we have to add a white stroke on the corners. For that, select our shape tool. Ensure that no layer is selected. Keep the fill as none. Stroke can be 2 pixels. And let's create a border like this. Let's take a copy of this by pressing on Command D. Let's open this, open the content. Over here in rectangle 1, inside rectangle path, I'm just going to reduce it. Perfect. Finally, on top of this, let's add our letter. I'm going to select the text tool and press over here once. The first letter is S. I'm just going to write S. Ensure that the anchor point is in the middle. Now coming over here, let's rotate it. We'll keep it as minus 90 degrees. Again, going back to the selection tool, let's place it in the middle. Change the font and the size. I'm going to keep it as Oswald. Again, you can keep anything that you want. And over here, let's increase it to around 120. Let's place it in the middle. Perfect. Now let's create a new composition and give it the name of the letter that you have just created. So I'm just going to call it as S. From over here, keep it the same as 920 by 1080. The duration can be 5 seconds and press on OK. So now inside the composition, we have to align the letter S. Don't worry, we only need to do it once. For all the other letters, we are going to simply copy paste. So let's drag the letter 1 over here. Let's place it on the corner. Now we have to duplicate the letter 9 more times. Press Ctrl D. Now select one of them and keep it all the way on the right side. In fact, I'm just going to do one small change over here. Coming to a letter. And for the letter, if I click on a text, I'm just going to increase it a bit. Now going back to S, select all the letters like this. One is at the start, one is at the end. Just keep one as unselected. I will tell you why in just a second. Come over here in Align, under Distribute, we have to click on Distribute Horizontally. Within a second, all the letters got properly distributed. Now let's ensure that all are aligned to the bottom as well. The reason why we did not select one is because we have to keep that one just outside the composition. Because later on, while doing the keyframes, we have to add a keyframes wherein this letter comes in and the last letter goes out. Perfect. Now coming back to our main panel, we are simply going to drag our letter to a timeline. Perfect. Now we have to repeat this process for all the other letters, but we are going to keep it super simple. Don't worry, I'm not going to tell you to repeat this process again and again. Let's do one thing. Let's get a new folder. In this, we'll just keep all the letters. In this, we'll keep all the letters. Now we need to take a copy of this. So let's press on Command D. We don't need this anymore, so I'm just going to close them and double click on our letter 2. All we need to do is simply click over here and press I. Let's go to our selection tool and place it in the middle. The reason we have kept it as I as it is going to be our second letter in the word simply put. Instead of I, you can add any other letter that you want. Now let's take a copy of S as well. I'm going to press Command D. We're going to call this as I. Let's double click over here. Right now you can see this composition is made up of letter 1, which is S. But you have to replace this by letter 2. For that, you can select all the layers over here in the timeline. pressing on command also select letter 2. Now just hold on to your option key or alt key and drag the letter 2 to a timeline. This way you can see everything got changed in a second. Now if you go back to the main, you can simply drag I and keep it on top of S. Just shift this upwards and keep it like this. Perfect. See, this saved us a lot of time. In case you want to change the colors from black to white, you can simply click over here and you can add the tint effect. Coming over here in the effects control panel, you can click on swap colors. This way the layer has been changed from black to white. For now, I'm just going to keep this as black. I'm going to keep the third and the fourth layer as white. Now in order to not waste your time, I'm going to do a speed run for all the remaining layers. Perfect. And let's drag our T to a timeline at the top. And let's just drag this over here. I'm going to select U and just going to add a tint effect on top of it. Let's swap the colors. Nice. Now let's start adding the keyframes. Select all the layers, ensure that your playhead is at the start and press on P. This will open up the position property. Now let's just click on the stopwatch. This will add a keyframe at the beginning. Let's zoom in. Now for the last layer, this keyframe is fine. For all the others, we are just going to distribute them by 5 frames. So coming over here, we are going to add another keyframe. Similarly, we are just going to repeat the process for the others. Now at the frame where this last keyframe ends, we have to move our last layer to the right. So I'm just going to move our x-axis and keep it over here. But see, we're facing one issue. We have now an empty place. That is the reason, if you remember, for all these letters, we had added extra letter on the left. But right now, it is not really visible. To ensure that it becomes visible, you simply need to select on this icon, which is called as collapse transformations. When you select that for all, you can see these layers are now becoming visible. So going back, if I play this, we'll get animation like this. So at this position, let's take this all the way inside. Perfect. Now, all we need to do is simply repeat the same process for all the other layers. So, going to 20 frames now. For I, again, I'm just going to keep it like this. Perfect. So, if I play this now, you'll get animation like this. Now coming over here, at this point, let's add the ending keyframe. In fact, we can do one thing. Let's zoom out a bit. Let's select our work area end. Let's place it at this point where our animation is ending. Let's zoom in. This way, as we have kept the work area end over here, our animation will move in a loop. But right now, as you can see, this is happening in a very linear way. To add a smooth motion, let's add easy ease. Let's select all the keyframes and press on F9. Select our first layer, go to graph editor, ensure that you have selected edit speed graph. Just select this and let's create a mountain like this. I'm just going to quickly repeat the process for the other layers as well. Perfect. This way, if I go back, and now if I play this, we are getting a beautiful smooth animation like this. See, we are getting a beautiful motion animation like this. Perfect. Now we have reached the last part of the animation. For that, let's select all the layers by pressing Ctrl A, and click over here, and click on Pre-compose. You can call this something like final animation, and press on OK. You can trim this comb over here. For that, right click over here and click on trim comb to work area. Finally, let's create a large composition and we'll call it as render. This can be something like 3 or 4 seconds and press on OK. Let's drag our final composition inside of it. We'll start by taking a copy of this. Let's hide the top one for now. For the bottom one, press R and let's rotate this by 90 degrees. Let's press on S and increase the scale. Now I'm just going to add a tint effect on top of this. Search for tint and just swap the colors. Now let's add an adjustment layer. I'm going to keep it over here above this layer. Let's just call this as background. And this one, I'm just going to call this as a cylinder. Now we're going to add two effects. The first one is going to be CC lens. Let's increase the size. We can keep it around 400. Also, we can play around with conversions and decrease it a bit. We'll get an effect like this. Next, let's add Gaussian blur. And you can increase it slightly. We'll keep it around 3 to 3.5. Perfect. Now let's unhide our cylinder layer. Let's search for CC cylinder effect. Over here, open up the rotation and we have to rotate it in this direction, like this. Let's open up the position as well. Let's see, yeah, this much looks fine. So if I go to the start, see, we are getting a beautiful effect like this. Now let's go to light. Let's properly put our light. I want to keep the light from this direction. Increase the height a bit. Perfect. Let's add drop shadow as well. Let's increase the opacity. Let's increase the distance as well. And increase the softness. Perfect. Let's keep it such a way that the shadow is on the left side. Perfect. Now let's add one more adjustment layer. Let's add the CC vignette effect. I'm going to increase it a bit and keep it like this. Now let's play this. Our animation ends somewhere over here. So we can simply trim this till this point. Right click over here and click on trim comb to work area. That way if I play this. Perfect. With this, we have got a beautiful cipher motion animation. If you loved the video, make sure to like and subscribe to the channel.